the kingdom of God in the waters of baptism. All of you rejoice, amen. So we're going to rejoice too, if you're happy.
So glad to have all of you here. A couple of housekeeping things before we get into our program. If you have parked your car on my left, your right, just in between this main auditorium and the primary, I want to ask you before this evening, so sometime this afternoon, you need to move your car and it can't go back there, because from tonight, we're going to be packing up, all of tomorrow, we're going to be packing up And if your car is still there, chances are it's going to have nice big forklift marks in the side as the forklift has picked it up and moved it so that we can actually pack it up. So please, this afternoon, there are no exceptions. You need to move all the cars that are in between the auditorium and the primary class this afternoon. Then just a reminder that there's a sale on at the shop this evening. Everything must go. Prices have been slashed. This is better than anything you'll find at Countdown or Pack and Save. And if you have any tabs that are still open, please can you settle them tonight? So tonight there's going to be a big sale on. And I know there's a whole lot of tabs for when the FPOS went down. Okay, you might have thought they were being very generous. No, please go settle your tabs tonight. Otherwise, we want to get right on with the program. I'm going to say a prayer, and right after prayer, we'll invite our kindy, because we're going to celebrate everything that has happened here at camp, right from the beginning, beginners. Thank you. Yeah, man. Beginners, all the way through, and so let's just acknowledge God's presence here this afternoon, and then we'll get underway. Lord, we thank you. We thank you that we can be here to celebrate the harvest that is already happening. We thank you that we can be here to celebrate what you've been doing in the lives of our children, what you've been doing in the hearts of all of those that have been here at camp, and most of all, just celebrating you, our great and powerful, mighty, awesome, loving, and wonderful God. You're the reason we gather. You're the reason we sing. You're the reason we express our joy and thanks. And so we just acknowledge your presence and thank you for being with us today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hello, campers. Oh, we're interesting. Hello, campers. Can you say beginners? Rocks. Yeah, same, because you're not in our department, so it's all good. Hey, this, we're at Beginners, and while they're our little video is playing, my name is Vodu. This is my cousin Wiley, and we're going to start you off. You can watch that, it's all good. We had a song that we, it takes a long time, so we have to wait for parents. So if you're, now I know what JT means. Are you ready?
whānau who have come every day. And what's awesome at beginners is that they are our grandparents, they are aunties and uncles, they are our mums and dads. And I just really want to honour everyone who took time to bring a little one to beginners, because it is a blessing for us who have run the program. So thank you. Yep, have a wonderful Sabbath.
Giver of light, giver of light, all that is good comes from above. This is our God shining on us. All that is good comes from above. This is our God shining on us. All that is good comes from above.
This is our fantastic Kindy group for 2018. We have been to Peru and we are going to share our theme song with you. They were so keen, they were singing it already, but there you go.
Weren't they fantastic, guys? I'm not biased at all, but I think those were the best two divisions that we're going to see. Give them another hand. Well done. As we continue celebrating, we have a baptism that is about to happen, and it's going to happen right over to your left. But luckily for you, we're going to live stream, so you can look up at the screens and we'll have you right in the heart of the action. And Parasupini this week has made a decision to give a heart for the Lord. And so we're going to ask Paris, if any of Paris's family are here, we'd love for you to go and stand next to the pool, the font, where she's going to get baptized. Pastor Eddie is going to be conducting the baptism. But now we'd like the family to make your way over there just to stand in support. And we as a congregation will be watching and celebrating with her on the screens.
Vista, hello to Paris. Everybody say, hi Paris.
Hi Paris.
Paris has been raised in the Seventh-day Adventist Church and has followed through with her parents and her family, the love that God has for her. She said to me that when she came to Big Camp, she was very reluctant to be here. But when she came and she joined in at the youth tent and heard the preaching of Pastor Rome, it really touched her, and she realized that this camp is where she's going to begin her journey with Jesus Christ. And so, Paris, together with your family and all of Big Camp 2018, it is my privilege as your pastor at Ponson Beach Church. To baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's pray. Father, we pray now for this child and for the baptism of your Holy Spirit. Just as she has been buried in the watery grave today, we pray that she would now be baptized and filled of your Spirit, and each day renewed by your presence in her. We thank you for Paris and pray your blessing over her and her family and her walk of following you. In Jesus' name we pray, and all of our church say, amen. Amen.
We're going to carry on celebrating with another baptism, and this time Richard Callahan has decided to give his heart to Jesus. Pastor Tara Strickland is going to be baptizing him. And so Richard, if any of Richard's family are wanting to celebrate and gather around with him, we ask that you go stand on the grass around the pool, just in solidarity with him. But we'll hand over to you, Pastor Tata.
Just like that.
We've got a real treat now with three baptisms. Pastor Ben Martin will be conducting these, and it's Caitlin Appel, Maya Charlie, and Brianna Kroll, who have all decided that they want to give their lives to Jesus. And so we're going to ask the families of these three young ladies if you can gather on the grass, and we're going to be baptizing Caitlin first, so if your family can be in front, then Maya, then Brianna. Over to you, Pastor Ben.
Thank you all. Hello, everyone. Caitlin's going to say hello to everybody. Hi, everyone. It's lovely to be here today. And this is a really special treat for me as a pastor, but I'm sure even more for the families and friends. Caitlin, who is standing here today, who came to camp on Sunday and expected a high week, a great time, and then we'll get a few short week, and then watch you make this move to Jesus today. I met Caitlin when I first came to the Hamilton Church. I think you guys were just freshly back from the United States. And Caitlin, I don't even want to say how old you were. I think you're only 6 or 7 at the time. And one of my great pleasures as a pastor has also been, and this has been true of all three of these girls, to be the chaplain of the Hamilton Assembly Avenue School. So for me now to see these guys, but Caitlin, especially you now making this commitment to Jesus, I know that my heart is full, but your mum and your dad and your younger brother and all the friends and family who are here now, they're just so excited to see that at the age that you are, you want to make this commitment to Christ. So we just want to say to you today, I'm very proud of you. So Caitlin, would you please take my hand? As I showed you before. And Caitlin, because of your love for Jesus Christ and your desire to make him Lord of your life, it's my privilege today as a minister of the gospel to baptize you now in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son. It's my great privilege today as not even being your current church pastor, Maya. I'm so grateful that you wanted to make this step that you asked me, but just for me to get to be up close and personal to watch you make this commitment to Jesus. It's just so very special. I'm so proud of you. It's where I came as well. And what a great thing that you can do it. You have this commitment and keep each other accountable. So, I can even say my arms. It doesn't matter. Maya, because of your love for Jesus Christ, because you want to make him Lord of your life, no matter where life takes you, you want to follow him. It's my great privilege as a minister of the gospel to baptize you now in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. One more introduction, everyone. Can everyone please say, hi, Brianna. Brianna's family, they are a huge part of our Hamilton church. Brianna's grandfather has been the head elder, mum is an elder, family members do everything. You know, when you belong to a church where there's so many in the family, it's pretty easy to just kind of feel that you're just another one. But Brianna, today, I know that you're not making this decision because that's your family church or because this is just what Paul wants to do. This is because Brianna wants to make him over to Jesus. This is because you're going to have Jesus. And I know because we've got all your family here, they're just feeling it right now. I can see their faces. They're just so excited to see you making this stand for Jesus. And once again, let me say how proud of I am and they are. Brianna, because of your love for Jesus Christ, because it's your desire to make him Lord and follow him wherever 5 to 8 students. Let him speak along with you, guide you, and lead you in the truth of your grace. It's my privilege today to minister the gospel to you. I pledge you in the name of the Father, and the Lord, and the Lord.
Give a hand for the high school once again. Looks like they had a real fun and great weekend. A fantastic time together. We're going to continue celebrating because did you know that what you celebrate, you get more of? And so here at camp, that's why we want to celebrate all these baptisms, because it's about the harvest, right? And so we want to get more of it. So we're going to celebrate the baptism of Miles Chapman and Maya King and Pastor Nigel King will be celebrating with them. So just the families of Miles and Maya, if you can make your way over the grass.
Thanks. I'm not actually going to be speaking on behalf of Miles today. I'm going to be asking his grandmother's sister. Miles doesn't come from a Christian background. He doesn't normally go to church. The only exposure he's had is he came to a weekend here 2 years ago. And then he's in a Catholic school, he's done all he can to learn about Jesus. But he made the decision that he wanted to come back, and he wanted to grab hold of much Jesus as he could when he came back to this camp. So Miles is here, he came and he sat all by himself in that tent because he didn't know anyone. But he has chosen Jesus this week, and it is such a privilege to be here today. But right now, I just wanted to give his grandmother's sister, a chance to pass them out, and she's going to say something on behalf of her.
Miles, we're just so proud of you. This is a very difficult decision for Miles to make because he hasn't got any Christianity in his home, and so it takes great courage for Miles to be able to stand up and say, "Yes, Lord, I want you in my life." And we're going to support Miles as much as we possibly can. I've given him my email address, he can Skype me, but he's also got his nana over there who will be there for him whenever. But it is truly a courageous decision, and thank you so much, Miles, for your dedication.
And so, Miles, do you love Jesus?
Yes.
Do you promise to follow him for the rest of your life? Church family, I invite you to raise your hand with me today as we baptize him together into this family. Miles, because you love Jesus and because you have promised to follow him for the rest of your life, it is my greatest privilege to baptize you now in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and the church says together.
Oh,
Jesus, and because you have promised to follow him for the rest of your life, it is my greatest privilege today to baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and the entire church says, Father God, we thank you for the decisions that have been made this week. God, that's the whole point of Big Camp. That's how it started, to spread the good news. Jesus, we thank you that the good news was received this week by so many people, and I thank you for the decisions for baptism, the decisions to follow you, to enter into a relationship with you, the decisions to renew relationships with you. Father, we just thank you for both of these young people. We thank you for their families. We just ask, God, that you bless them. You cover them. May they remember this day as an awesome, joyous day, a day that they entered into relationship with you publicly. Thank you, Father. We just ask that you watch over them also. We trust them into your hands. And Lord, we know as a church we are now responsible to look after them as well. And so I pray you equip us and empower us to do that. Thank you, Jesus. We love you and praise you in your holy name. Amen. Thank you very much, church.
Hey, good afternoon, family. Just a show of hands, you can feel the presence of God this afternoon. Awesome, awesome. Hey, I'm just so privileged to be in the coolest team. The youth team, being young myself. Seriously, we've just had a fun time at the youth team. Really felt the presence of God with Pastor Roman, an awesome team. And the song that we're going to sing this afternoon is Better Is One Day in Your Courts Than a Thousand Elsewhere, and mixed in with an old classic, Andre Crouch classic, all because of Jesus. Because if there's anything that was really special and that I witnessed was young people having an encounter with Jesus Christ. And so, hope you enjoy this.
There is one day in your heart.
Indeed, we are here, church, to continue celebrating what God has done and is doing in the harvest. And so we're going to continue with some baptisms. Next is going to be Michelle Mandembo, Jaden McKinnon-Peel, Blair Borden, and Tanner Brooking. And Pastor Anton van Wyk is going to be leading in these. Over to you, Pastor Anton.
Good afternoon, everyone. The Holy Spirit's been really active this week. And with me here is Michelle. She's the star in our church. All the young people are my children, but she's an outstanding one. Full of talent, full of the Holy Spirit. She told me today she's leading Ed Sheeran in One Direction, and she's holding on to Jesus. So what a tremendous moment for Michelle and her family. They're right behind me here, so I'm going to ask them just to come close. Our families put their hands in the water when we baptize their children, so we can build that spiritual umbilical cord for the future, and that's important. She'll be a year 9 student at Longmont Adventist College this year. We invite your prayers and your love for her. She's going to blossom for the kingdom and the kingdom harvest. Michelle, it's my privilege today to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Someone we're very proud of in Palmerston North, and we look forward to God doing amazing things with and through his life. Behind me, his family, they'll put their hands in the water now, and they also want to sing, so we'll have to fill it in. We'll just do the first verse of that song, God. Alright. Jaden, so wonderful to know you. You're my son, you're one of my colleagues in ministry. You are vibrant, vital, and Jesus burns in your heart. May God bless you. It's my privilege today to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Girls from Palmerston North. We have great girls in our city. And she stood firm and she stood solid. And she introduced him to the church family and to things that she holds dear. And when they were married in 2016, it was my privilege to do that for them. Then their little girl came along, the baby, in the September last year. And Blair and them decided to come to camp, but they didn't have the budget to come every night from Tauranga. So they thought it's a camp, camps are all the same, they'll just come two or three nights. They landed up coming every night, burning the budget. And the Holy Spirit touched his life again. Pastor Hugh Heenan here from Hastings has been studying with him. I've done some work with him. This man is a mechanical engineer. He's got a beautiful wife, Alexandra, beautiful baby. Life is beginning for him today. And God is going to move, mate. You better hold on. It's going to be great. And God bless you. And give everyone a smile. They're a great God. We don't know how we're going to get him down today, but we'll work with God. Blair, it's my privilege today to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May God be behind you and over you and under you, and you will enjoy life as you have never before. We baptize you now into the kingdom harvest. Amen.
Amen.
To the youth team where Pastor Rome was preaching. Vice Deacon Blair, tremendous impact by the Holy Spirit. And here we have this beautiful young man today to release him from the kingdom harvest that is out there. He prays beautifully. He's someone to be proud of. His mom and dad just celebrated their 20th anniversary. So much happening for this family. Grandparents here behind me. They're a little bit old. We hope they can handle the words when they're old, but that's great. So today, my mate, it's a wonderful privilege to baptize you. And I just look forward to see what God's going to do in us. Stand strong, man. The old devil's not happy today, eh? But we'll give him reason not to be.
No, they're not.
God bless you. One of the millennials kneeling before you, right? Tanner, you make us proud. You've stood out, you've stood up, and you've stood tall for Jesus. Today is a wonderful privilege to baptize you. And we do that in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We'll just say pray for today. He wants me to pray. Father God, it's like a tender reed in this world. A world full of confusion. We've got to release Tanner into this world. What his parents have taught him, the love and input of his grandparents and family, we know that will stand him in good stead. Thank you for the preaching of the word this week that has riveted your love in his life and darted into his heart the desire to build the kingdom of God. Father, bless him, love him. Don't leave him for a moment as you promised. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Friends, we're going to transition to Pastor Eddie on stage there. Please, if the Holy Spirit's nudging you today, talk to us, talk to one of the pastors, talk to one of your family. Let's do the kingdom work. Amen.
Amen. On Wednesday evening, I visited the high school tent, and I felt so old in there. The music was a little louder than I would prefer, and the energy was a bit more than I could muster myself. But when the word was preached and Pastor Jack Ryder called, and 15 young people stood up, went forth, saying that they would like to be baptized. So some of them have been baptized today, and some of them are going to go back to their local churches to prepare to be baptized. I was sitting at the back when the meeting finished, and one of the young girls came past me, and she stopped and she said, "Pastor Eddie, I almost went to the front. I almost went to the front, but I just... I don't know if this is the time, but I just have to feel that this is the time." So there's somebody here today, somebody here in this building. You've been inspired today. Maybe it's one of your friends. And I've been right across the campus this week and seeing the great work in beginners, kindergarten, primary and junior, high school and the youth. There's somebody here today. You're thinking, yeah, I'd like to be baptized as well. So I'm going to extend the call to you, give you the opportunity. While Sumiti sings the first verse, and we'll join him in the chorus of this wonderful, wonderful song. This power in the blood. Blood of Jesus Christ. Why don't you stand today? One of your family, a Big Camp family 2018. want you to come forward and say, I'm going to go back home to my church and prepare to be baptized. There's somebody sitting next to that person that can encourage that person today. Get them to stand today and come forward to be baptized. Sweetie, please take us forward.
Amen. Who made that decision in the Holy Spirit?
someone that loves you. Let them know that you've been prompted and you'd like to make that decision and you'd like to be prepared for baptism when you get back to your local church. Has God been good to us here at Big Camp 2018? It's been such a wonderful time. And so as we come to a close this afternoon and we return back to our various programs this evening for our final farewells, it's my privilege to thank each and every one of you for making Big Camp such a success. Could we put our hands together and praise God? I'd like to ask if you could please these young people that have made these decisions today and others who have made decisions and are going back to be prepared for baptism, please look after them. Please look after, care for them. And just one word, please. Please be kind to them. I'd like to thank, firstly, our Big Camp committee, Andrew West and Bruce Mason and all of their team. Could we please put our hands together for the Big Camp committee? Now, working right alongside them with the speakers and the music teams are an army of volunteers, our conference staff, teachers and pastors, and they have just worked so hard this whole week, beginning of the storm and finishing off with the baptism. Please put your hands together for all of our team. My final thanks today is to the Tui Ridge Park staff, beginning with Norm King, our manager, and also Wayne Goodchild. He has been acting manager and has been taking care of us this whole week, and all of the Tui Ridge Park team. Haven't they done an amazing job? Put our hands together for Tui Ridge Park. I've been absolutely blessed with God's calling upon our conference. So once again today, I commission you and I send you to make disciples of Jesus Christ, to make ministers and ministries for Jesus Christ, so that we can transform communities right across Aotearoa for the glory of God and to the blessing of Jesus Christ and the presence of His Holy Spirit. Please put your hands together for what God has done for us here. I'd like to ask you to stand together as we sing the song of worship and praise to close this program this afternoon. Let's stand together. Amen. Hold on to somebody while I pray for the church right now. Hold somebody's hand, put your arm around somebody as we pray for the church of God right now. Lord, it's become abundantly clear for us this week that it's time. It's time to patiently serve you and to urgently seek your presence. It's time to patiently trust you and to urgently resist being little gods. It's time to patiently wait for Jesus to come and urgently proclaim that the kingdom of God is near. So Lord, today, these are your people. I ask, Lord, may your blessings flow upon them. May heaven rain down blessings abundant on each one. You know, Lord, the prayers of their hearts. You know the deepest, deepest needs. And I pray, Lord, today, please answer the prayers of your people. I pray, Lord, today, for a sinful people. I pray, Lord, please, that you would look at your Son, Jesus Christ. We believe in him. We believe what he has done for us. And today, Lord, I pray, please forgive your people. Accept them anew in the righteousness of Jesus. And Lord, please, walk with them as they follow your Holy Spirit into the harvest. And may we be listening to the leading of your Spirit and to be obedient to your Spirit's call. Today, Lord, I pray that your healing would be upon our church in North New Zealand. Hurts, the pain, whatever it is, we just leave it here. We go refreshed, renewed for you and for your cause. So, Lord, today, it's just amazed us what you've done with the weather. How can it just storm in Rotorua yesterday but not here at Two Ridges? It's always the other way around. But your favor has smiled on us. We know we are blessed and we know that you are speaking to us, calling us and asking us to believe you deeper than we have ever believed you before. So as we leave this spiritual home of the North New Zealand Conference this weekend, please, Lord, protect your people. Look after them. Comfort them when they're down, when they're down. Lift them up every time they fall. And may their walk and their talk, everything that they do and say, always be for you and for your blessed calling upon our lives. Their gifts, their resources, all, Lord, multiply and may it be for you and for. Maybe we come back here in 2 years time. But if not, Lord, we just cannot wait to see your blessed face. So, Lord, thank you for accepting us. We love you. All that we have done, all that we have said here at Two Ridge Park this week, it's our offering, it's our sacrifice. May it be sweet smelling on the altar, Lord, and pleasing to you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for accepting us. These things we do and say. In the name of our blessed and victorious Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and all of his blessed church, say, Amen.